Good evening, friends. Welcome to Atonics Facebook Live at 5:30. Hi, friends. I am your friend Saurabh from Atonics Technical and Service Department. I hope you're watching our Facebook Live video at every day 5:30 p.m., where we are showing our Atonics product and describing some technical details. So you will get some technical knowledge or some ideas of our Atonics product. And definitely that will be very useful for your Atonics for different types of automation applications. So today we will cover one of our product, that is a area sensor, BWC series, that is a cross beam type area sensors. So today we will see one of our sensor, that is a area sensor, that is a BWC series. BWC series, it is a cross beam type area sensors. Friends, we have different types of area sensors like BWE, BWC, BWP or BW series. So first I will go with the BWE series, that is mostly used for the elevator applications, where for the elevator door applications it is used, that is the BWE series. Today we will see that BWC series, that is a cross beam type area sensors. Another one we have a BW series, that is a normal area sensors. And the next one is the BWP, that is plastic body, the area sensors. And the most of rest of the area sensors we have in the aluminum body. For the plastic body BWP, it comes with the BWP series. And the next one is the BWPK, that is used for the machinery applications. For the precautions for the human interface between the machines, it will avoid. So that kind of area sensors we have. So one of our area sensors we will see today, that is BWC series. Before going to details in the BWC series, I will tell some technical specifications of BWC series, that is a cross beam type area sensors. And I will show you one small demo or once for our BWC series. So that's why I bring some area sensors that I will show you next. First, I will tell you some technically features of our BWC series. That is the BWC area sensor. It is a three-point cross beam netting method that minimize the non-sensing area that is in the BWC series, and it increase the sensing ability for this cross beam netting method. By using that cross beam netting method, it minimizes the long sensing area, that is non-sensing area, and so almost it increased sensing ability. The long sensing distance, it has a sensing distance up to the 7 meter, so it having very long sensing distance, that is up to the 7 meter. It has a 7 model of a of number of optical axes, that is a optical axis that it has up to 4 to 20, that is different types of optical axes it has. It has also has the optical axis pitch, that is 40 to 80 mm, that is sensing distance between the rays, that is the optical axis pitch. We have up to 40 or 80 mm, and the sensing height, the sensing height should be 120 mm to 1040 mm. It has a built-in interference protection circuit and the self-diagnosis functions also. It has a high luminous indicator for the emitter and the receiver to check the status at side and for the long distance. It comes with the IP65 protections, and it also has a dark on and light on operation mode that we will see yesterday also, the dark on and light on operation mode. And it also has the M10 open collector output, so you can feed that output to your PLC as per your applications. So I will show you that the area sensor first, then you will get some ideas. Hi friends, so this is our area sensors. I hope you can see here, that is our model number, BWC40-12H. As I told you, this is our model number, and this is one of our area sensors. You can see here the connector and the number of pins and the number of pin, why it is used for. As per the brown is for the voltage, white is for the synchronization, blue is for the zero hold, and the black is for the output. So this one is the emitter part. So you can see here BWC40-H12 is, it's the emitter part. And this is one of the receiver part, BWC40-12H, that is the model number. You can see here this is the receiver. So you need the emitter and receiver for the area sensors. So this is our area sensor. I keep these area sensors here, and I hope you can see the lights here that are indicating red light and green light. If I put the object between that, if I keep the object between that, it will sense the and it will indicate the here also. I hope friend you can see. Now normally it is a green. If I put my hand between the sensors, it is showing red. That is a red LED. And you will get the NPN out, open connector output. And you will get the NPN open connector output at the black end of the black end wire of this area sensors. So you can feed that output to your PLC. As I told you, we have also different types of applications here. Before that, I am going to applications. It also need a cable that is for the connection. It is a connector type sensor, so it come with the connectors, and you need one connector cables. That is a four terminal that we also have, that we call the CID4-3T. 3 is for the 3 meter. So CID4-3T, it's a cable. It come. We have to use this cable for the connection of these sensors. Similarly, in receiver side, I connect the cable also. I hope, friend, you can see the board here, where I write some applications. The most area sensors that I told you before also, the types of area sensors that we have. We have different types of area sensors. BWE series, that is used in elevator, as I told you. BW series, that is normal area sensor, straight beam. BWC series, that is a cross beam type area sensor. BWP, that having the plastic body. And the BWPK, BW is our new one sensor, that is for the elevator use applications. And BWPK series, that is used in for the machinery applications in industry, or to avoid the for the precautions for the humans to enter the hand into the machines. So we can see here application, that is a sensing arrival of a component. Consider there is a one conveyor and the object is moving on that, and you have to sense that object on the conveyor. So the, by using this sensor, you can also sense the arrival of the component by placing these two sensors, that is emitter and the receiver. So you will get the output. Once the object is passed between that, you will get the output. We also have the light curtain sensors. Also, if you consider the one CNC machine, is there are some job making machines in mechanical factories. So once the door is closed, you have to, if you use these sensors for the area sensors, for that application it is also useful. So it is very useful sensors for the human also, to avoid some accidental cases in the industries with different types of machines in the mechanical industry. This is one of our Atonics product, that is the area sensor BWC that we saw today, that is a cross beam area sensors. We have different types of area sensors also. As per your application, you can select the proper area sensors and you can use in your different applications. So that is for the today's topic, that is the area sensors. I told you already the, all the features of these area sensors. If you have still any query regarding the area sensors or any Atonics product, you can call us on our toll-free number, that is 1-800-220-235. Or you can simply mail us india@atonics.com. I will repeat the toll number 1-800-220-235. Or our mail ID is india@atonics.com. I hope you enjoy the video or you get some technical details of our Atonics product. Thanks for joining today's section. Have a great day.